Hello, I'm Samara. I'm a PhD student in the Geometric Computing Lab at EPFL. Our project 3D Weaving with Curved Ribbons presents a simulation and optimization framework that produces free-form woven structures. We were inspired by the art of basket weaving, where people build 3D objects using natural materials such as bamboo. These materials can be easily cut into straight ribbons that align with the material's fiber directions. However, with modern fabrication technology, such as laser cutting, we can fabricate ribbons of arbitrary shapes. In this case, if we fabricate a set of planar ribbons shown on the right, we can weave them to get this word. This is one of the example outputs of our framework. Once our algorithm finds the optimal set of ribbons, the fabrication process to obtain the 3D target shape is straightforward. We were able to produce a variety of doubly curved freeform woven surfaces. Our framework can handle non-orientable surfaces and open boundaries. To understand how it works, let's go back to the beginning and start with the basic principles of weaving. Here are the two main regular weaving patterns, the biaxial weave and the triaxial weave, named after the number of parallel families of ribbons in the weave. The ribbons are interlaced to increase the stabilizing friction forces. The typical ribbons used in basket weaving are often much wider than its thickness, so that it's easy to bend the ribbon along their weak axis, but almost impossible along the stiff axis. With the regular pattern, the weave can be deformed as a developable surface. But to obtain non-zero Gaussian curvature, we need to deviate from the regular pattern. The first method is to vary the spacings between the ribbons. We can push the center ribbons further apart to get positive curvature, or push them tighter to get negative curvature. But as the curvature increases, the ribbons will eventually collide. A second well-known practice is to introduce topological singularities into the weaving pattern. This is similar to how one can make a cone from a flat piece of paper. For the triaxial pattern, replacing one of the hexagons by a pentagon or any polygon with less than six sides will induce positive Gaussian curvature. And replacing it with a heptagon or any polygon with more than six sides will induce negative Gaussian curvature. A third method to introduce curvature is to use ribbons that are curved in their planar rest states. For example, in the set of modules here, if the ribbons bend away from the hexagon, then the patch will have positive curvature. If the ribbons bend towards the hexagon, then we get patches with negative curvature. Compared to the previous two methods, changing the ribbon planar shapes changes the 3D curvature smoothly, but still covers a good range of positive and negative curvatures. The first two methods has been extensively explored in existing basket weaving techniques. Traditionally, topological singularities only appear in a few locations, such as the corners of the basket. Artist Alison Martin has created many complex surfaces by empirically studying the effects of singularities. This method for 3D shape approximation using 2D material system has also gained popularity in the graphics community. During SIGGRAPH 2019, one of my co-authors, Julian Panetta, presented a new type of deployable structures named eggshell. Eggshells has regular spacings between the beams and pop into 3D during the expansion deformation. At the same conference, Vector and colleagues proposed an optimization algorithm for finding geodesic foliations that can be converted into woven surfaces with straight ribbons. The idea of using curved ribbons has also been explored in various contexts. Alkman and colleagues proposed a method to compute dense weaving pattern. A related geometric strategy was also explored by James Malice. This woven sphere is designed by Anna and Lena Shepherd using manually drawn curves. Recently, some colleagues from the mechanical engineering departments at EPFL and MIT have proposed the parametric unit cell approach to assemble woven structures using a combination of straight ribbons and circular arcs. One common component that's missing from these existing works is incorporating the physical behaviors of the ribbons into the design process. Weaving materials are often bending active elements, and their elastic behaviors can have a significant and interesting impact on the equilibrium shape of the woven structure. In our work, we apply physics-based simulation to accurately model the behaviors of ribbons, as well as their interactions with other ribbons in this coupled system. As you can see in the videos here, the optimized structure will settle reliably back into the predicted shape, even after extreme deformations. We optimize over ribbons with arbitrary curvature, and this design freedom greatly expands the space of achievable 3D shapes. Our inverse design optimization is based on the eggshell design method, and we extended the framework to handle curved ribbon weaving. To explain our design framework, I will first describe the representation we use for woven structures. Then I will present our simulation and inverse design optimization algorithms. We built a collection of physical models to validate our method, and I'll explain this process in more details. Finally, I'll discuss several interesting results and applications. To simulate the physical behaviors of the ribbons, we used the popular discrete elastic rods model. Representing the ribbon as a framed polygonal curve, the model allows us to efficiently compute the stretching, bending, and twisting energy of the ribbon. The simulation variables for each ribbon segment include the positions of the centerline vertices and the material frame angle for each centerline edge that are used to compute the twisting energy. In order to connect the continuing segment and model the interaction between crossing segments, we define some additional variables. Each crossing is parameterized by its position, orientation, and the angle variable. To account for the ribbon thickness and the interlacing weaving pattern, each crossing also has a positional offset parameter for its adjacent ribbon segments. This crossing model implicitly constrains the ribbons to lie flat on top of each other to promote stability in the woven structure. Ribbon sliding can also occur naturally through the length variation of continuing ribbon segments. We take an embedded graph as the input weaving pattern. Our algorithm will automatically pair up edges to trace out ribbons. We initialize all ribbons to be straight. In our framework, we can specify the ribbons to have spatially varying stiffness by changing its cross-sections. We can then find the equilibrium state of the initial woven structure. This is done by minimizing the elastic energy of the structure, which is just the sum of elastic energy in all ribbon segments. The vector x contains all the simulation variables. We could implement the crossings directly as equality constraints. For example, the ribbon's material frame normal should align with the crossing's normal, and the endpoint position should be the crossing position plus the interleaving offset. However, this constraint problem would be too expensive to use in the later inverse design optimization. Instead, we use a reduced representation where the end edges of the ribbon segments are directly configured by the crossings, and only the internal edges are free variables. We encode this nonlinear transformation in the VR function. The ribbons in the initial equilibrium state have a lot of twisting and buckling, and the crossings experience high stresses that will not be balanced by the friction forces between the ribbons. This is because this topology has no singularities, and the straight ribbon weave cannot conform to the target 3D curvatures. To find a stable woven structure with better shape approximation and lower stresses, we numerically optimize over curved ribbons. In our inverse design method, the optimization parameters are the length and curvature of the ribbons. To compute these parameters, we solve a multi-objective optimization problem. Our objectives include approximate the target shape as closely as possible, reducing the elastic energy, and reducing the contact forces between the ribbons. For the target fitting objective, we compute the shortest distance from the ribbon to the target surface by projecting ribbons to the target mesh. We also use the distance from the ribbon to the input crossing positions as a regularization. Under this term, the ribbons are allowed to slide on the target surface during the optimization, but not away from it. We have discussed the elastic energy in the equilibrium problem. Previously, the length and curvature of the elastic rods are constant, but now the equilibrium state x star will be a function of these design parameters. In order to remove the rigid motion degrees of freedom, we could fix a single crossing's position and orientation. This works fine when we just want the equilibrium state, but because the initial state of the ribbons have lots of twisting, the crossing might not be on the target surface, and its normal might not align with the surface normal. So fixing it will be in direct conflict with the surface closeness term. To resolve this issue, we add the surface closeness objective function to the equilibrium problem with a small weight. This weight should be high enough to remove rigid transformations, but low enough so that we don't introduce fictitious forces into the equilibrium problem. Once we know the elastic energy stored in the ribbons, we can compute the contact forces at the crossing as the gradient of the elastic energy with respect to the crossing positions. These forces can be decomposed into separation or compressive forces along the normal direction and tangential forces. In order to have a stable weave, we want to remove all separation forces and lower the tangential forces so that they can be compensated by static friction. We use an activation threshold and set it to be slightly negative to promote strictly compressive forces. We found through experiments that because both the length and curvature are free variables, if we do not apply any regularization, the ribbons will get longer and longer and have self-intersections. If we simply regularize the length of the ribbons, we get a reasonable result, but the ribbons tend to be piecewise linear and have kinks at the crossings. So we add another regularization term on the curvature to promote smooth ribbons. The weights of these terms give the user some design freedom. A final important component is that we want the optimization to find good design parameters while keeping the structures in static equilibrium, so that the forces and the distance to the target surface we compute for the objective are actually meaningful. This means that we need to rerun the nonlinear equilibrium solve at each iteration of the design optimization. This nested optimization problem is very challenging to solve. We typically need to use high-resolution centerline in the elastic rod model to accurately simulate curved ribbons. For example, we have over 100,000 variables for the woven Klein bottle. We computed explicit gradient and Hessian formulas for the equilibrium problem and applied a Newton solver so that this inner loop converges rapidly. On the other hand, the full Hessian of the design problem is intractable to compute, especially since we already need the gradients of the elastic energy in the objective function of the contact term. So we choose to use a Newton CG optimization algorithm combined with the trust region method for solving the design problem. We perform exact first and second order sensitivity analysis to obtain the Hessian vector product information needed for Newton CG. Additionally, we speed up the equilibrium solve by finding a good initial guess from the quadratic Taylor expansion of the previous equilibrium state. Unfortunately, the full design optimization is still too hard to solve directly, so we propose a multi-stage solver. The initial woven structure with straight ribbons tend to behave poorly because the ribbons have lots of twisting and buckling. So in the first stage, we fix the crossing's position variables on the target surface and minimizing the elastic energy while allowing both the simulation variables and design variables to change. This formulation basically allows forces of arbitrary magnitude holding down the crossings, so its local minimum is not a true equilibrium state. But it rapidly introduces curvature into the straight ribbons and navigate out of the difficult energy landscape where a small change to the design parameters causes the ribbon to pop from one configuration to another. After stage one, the structure is in a much more stable configuration, but once we release the pinned crossings, it will deviate from the target surface again. In this example, the main deviations happen in the region with negative mean curvature. In stage two, we solve the nested optimization problem defined earlier, but without the highly nonlinear contact forces term. The resulting structure in equilibrium closely approximates the target surface. At this point, we evaluate the contact forces at all crossings. If we observe separation forces, we proceed to stage three, where the contact force term is added back to the objective. Even though the magnitude of the changes to the design parameters is small, stage three can play an important role in finding a stable structure. In this example, all separation forces are removed, and the tangential forces are significantly reduced. Here is a recording of the optimization process. Again, the colors encode the distance from the woven structure to the target surface. You can see that this value is decreasing while the ribbon is going from straight to curved. That concludes a summary of our design framework. Next, I would like to show the fabrication process and some results. We integrate the length and curvature given by the optimization algorithm to compute the planar ribbon pattern and send that to a laser cutting machine. We also engraved the crossing numbers on the physical ribbons and provided a visualization app to facilitate the weaving process. During the assembly, we used some temporary pins to fix the ribbons. This model took around 2 hours to weave. Once the weaving is done, we only need pins at the boundary crossings. In order to systematically evaluate the accuracy of our inverse design method, we scanned and reconstructed all the models we fabricated. For this model, the maximum deviation from the target surface is less than 2% of the bounding box diagonal. We provide the complete set of quantitative comparisons in the supplementary materials for all the models we fabricated. We also included the vector files for the ribbon patterns, and we invite you to weave these models yourself. You might be wondering a missing piece in our pipeline. That is, how is the input topology graph generated? Because curved weaving drastically increases the design space, we impose very little constraints on the input topology graph. In traditional straight ribbon weaving, you will need to carefully place the singularities, and the geometry of the target shape dictates the weaving pattern. But that's not the case in our method. Here, we show three different patterns for the same target shape. The first topology is created by my colleague Florin using the design tool Rhino. The other two topologies are automatically generated using Instant Mesh. Here is the comparison of two woven client bottles. The left one is woven by Alison with straight ribbons only. It requires many topological singularities, and the discrete nature of singularities often leads to local curvature concentrations. When we weave with optimized curved ribbons, we can approximate the 3D curvatures smoothly. Because the client bottle has Euler characteristic zero, we don't need to include any singularity in the topology. Of course, singularities can still be helpful in curved ribbon weaving, either out of necessity for target shapes of spherical topology, or they can be used to control the weaving pattern. Here's a fun example where we can morph a sphere into a cat continuously by changing the curvature of the ribbon without changing the topology of the weave. It exploits the fact that curved ribbon weaving can change the 3D curvature continuously, which is not possible for straight ribbons. We envision curved ribbon weaving to be used in architecture, furniture design, personalized medical devices, and many exciting new applications. Our physics-based simulation framework can easily integrate additional constraints such as gravity and other loading scenarios. For this clamp model, if we do not apply any special constraints on the boundary, then the equilibrium shape is far from the target. Because there are many ribbons traversing across the model with high bending forces, such as the one highlighted in blue here. So in this case, we explicitly fix the boundary curve. A potential research direction is to study the shape space of woven structures. In our experiments, we haven't encountered any failure cases for closed surface, but it will be interesting to know, for example, what are the optimal external forces required for a structure with open boundary to stay in the target shape. Another very exciting future direction is to explore the interplay between topological singularities and ribbon curvature, and jointly optimize the topology and the ribbon shape. During the fabrication process, we had to deal with additional constraints such as the limited dimension of the laser cutting machine. For models with long ribbons, we have to separate them into smaller segments and reconnect them later. This splitting and packing process is currently done manually, and it will be very helpful to have an algorithm that finds the best ribbon layout to reduce material waste. Lastly, it will be very cool to realize the morphing process shown earlier with actuated ribbons. This could be a new way to design shape-shifting structures. I would like to thank all my collaborators for their time and effort. This project will not be possible without each and every one of them. We also want to thank the anonymous reviewers for their feedback. Our research is funded by the Swiss National Science Foundation and the NCCR Digital Fabrication Initiative. Thank you for watching.